Attorney General Jeff Sessions exercised his authority Monday as the ultimate reviewer of the immigration court system to overrule a series of Obama-era decisions that were allowing the radical expansion of the American asylum system. Asylum is part of the Immigration and Nationality Act, INA. In 1980, it was defined to allow entry to the United States for people who face persecution, typically by their home country's governments, for their race, religion, nationality, membership in a particular social group, or political opinion. Traditionally, the social group category was seen as akin to the others, a defined group with identifiable characteristics whose members face danger and persecution. Asylum was for any communist Afghans who refused to be drafted into the Soviet occupation's army, Jehovah's Witnesses who faced arrest for holding meetings, and so on. Open borders groups and the immigration bar have for years sought to turn the exception of asylum for persecuted groups into a rule that people more likely to be victims of ordinary crime in their home countries have a right to move to the United States. In 2005, for example, an immigration lawyer unsuccessfully asked a federal appeals court to expand asylum to cover young, attractive Albanian women, because they were more likely to be forced into prostitution. In 2011, a lawsuit asked a different court to do the same for people who were resistant to gangs. Sessions's opinion Monday, matter of AB, likely forecloses, for now, this effort to use existing immigration law to force the United States to admit more and more people who enter the country without authorization and claim asylum based on dangers inherent in the less developed countries from which they come. Monday's action represents another example of Sessions using his own authority as Attorney General to effect these same aims. Last month, he used the same authority to restrict the circumstances in which immigration judges can drop deportation cases. Sessions has also shifted prosecutors and immigration judges to the border to more quickly handle asylum claimants and sought, where possible, to prosecute immigration lawyers engaging in asylum fraud to keep their clients in the U.S.